A cardiac emergency can happen anywhere. Be prepared with a simple technique known as compression-only CPR. You can learn it in minutes, it's easy to remember, and it can help save a life. If someone suddenly collapses, check the scene for safety. Then, check to see if the person responds to you using the shout, tap, shout technique. At the same time, check for breathing, life-threatening bleeding, or another life-threatening condition. Are you okay? Are you okay? If at any time you determine the person is experiencing a life-threatening emergency, call 911 and get the first aid kit and AED or tell someone to do so. Anna, call 911 and get the first aid kit and AED. Then, if they are unresponsive and not breathing or only gasping, begin compression-only CPR. First, ensure that the person is on their back on a firm, flat surface, such as the ground. If they are lying on a bed or couch, carefully move them to the floor. Next, kneel beside them, like this, with your knees near the person's body and spread about shoulder-width apart. Place the heel of one hand in the center of their chest with your other hand on top. Now, interlace your fingers and make sure they are up off the chest. Then, position your body so that your shoulders are directly over your hands. Lock your elbows to keep your arms straight. This technique allows you to use your body weight to help compress the chest. You are now in the correct position to give compressions. When giving compressions, push hard and fast. Compress the chest to a depth of at least 2 inches and a rate of between 100 and 120 compressions per minute, or about one every half second. After each compression, let the chest return to its normal position. Watch as I demonstrate just a few chest compressions so you can see what they look like. Finally, keep going. Continue giving compressions until you notice an obvious sign of life, like breathing, an AED is ready, a trained responder is available to take over compressions, EMS personnel arrive and begin their care of the person, you are alone and too tired to continue, or the scene becomes unsafe. If you would like to learn how to give full CPR and use an AED, you can take an American Red Cross CPR AED course. Check out redcross.org for more information.